Hello and welcome to episode 4 of the Road to Rooney. My name is Canty in PS3, and this is there are 4 matches in this episode. Up first is Estrellas. I'm going to see all the goals as well. That's a new thing. And this guy has a quality team, and they gel well early on in the game to send Fernando Torres through. He isn't picked up, and I kind of know this is going in from the moment that he gets the ball at his feet. It goes in. This guy over-celebrates a wee bit, but I don't really mind people celebrating goals, so long as it's not a tramp goal, in which case if you celebrate, you're an arsehole. But nothing else happens in the first half, not many chances. In the second half, Arteta wins the ball back, Fletcher and Bibertelli combine. Fletcher misses his shot, but Bibertelli will slot that home to make it 1-1. After 51 minutes. Bibertelli, by the way, is Mario Balotelli's nickname. He once had trouble putting on a training bib. And actually needed help from a coaching staff member, and he was just nicknamed Bibertelli. Speaking of which, he just won a penalty there, Stonewall. I meant to put Arteta on this, but ended up putting Nasri. I wasn't going to change it, but it doesn't matter because Nasri is going to score anyway. 2-1 after 60 minutes, and this is where I start to turn the screw, and you know, just, I get on top in the game. Lots of chances, and Bibertelli goes close here. I wish that had gone in. It would have been a nice goal. The pass was lovely. But Mikel Arteta steps back into his role as a set-piece taker, whips in that corner, and who is on hand to head home? Rio Ferdinand. Rio. That makes it 3-1 after 64 minutes, and unfortunately, I can't score again. That is how this match ended, 3-1. Not too bad. I wish I hadn't conceded so early on, because I did manage to control his Torres through most of that game, 741 coins, and the match details will prove that I deserve to win. Again, I don't mind showing you the match details because, I don't know, I think it's mildly interesting to see. 10 shots to his 3, 3 of mine went in, so yeah, I deserve to win. I tweak with the team again and into a game with Samso192 or something like that, and his team is called Samso. I don't know what kind of team he was creating, just gold players I think, or players he likes, or I don't know. But this game was hella frustrating. I just couldn't score, it was laggy as hell as well. So when I did score this effort, I was over the moon thinking, yes, nothing had happened in the first half, not much was going to happen in the second half. So when I scored that, I thought that would be the last goal of the game, but no, Galas makes an absolute mess of this by not jumping, not even trying to get that ball, and Dimitar Berbatov makes it 1-1. Luckily for me, even though this game was laggy, this dude decided that we were going to do extra time and penalties. And this goal, well, what a goal to win a match. Just look at this. Fumble. I would have given that goal to Darren Bent. I wouldn't have given it an own goal to Julian Lescott. But yeah, what are you going to do? That is how the match ended. 2-1 to Force 12. Another win for me. 7.6 shows that Cech was the man of the match. I actually didn't have, I don't know, this match. I didn't have a single shot in the first half of this match. But as you can see, I came out on top in the end with 6 on target to his 4. It is what it is. I will take it. I'll move on. This guy, Furrasra, blah, 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 was an absolute jerk of a human being. Kept hacking me down, kept playing the long ball to nobody in particular, and that's what happens when you hack people down constantly. I don't think he knew how not to tackle with the slide. Arteta does step up to take this penalty. And he again makes no mistake. Bam. Have it. 1-0 after only 25 minutes. Well, that's actually not only 25 minutes. 1-0 in the middle of the first half. And I just didn't enjoy playing this game, if I'm honest. Ramirez does... This is a quite a nice goal, actually. Ramirez, from the angle, powers it into the top corner. No keeper in the world is going to stop that, mind you. It was past him and it was still not in the net, technically. So he gets his shoe polished. I don't even want to talk about this game. It was rubbish. The goals weren't too bad. They were fairly well made, fairly easily created. That was a nice finish from Sean Wright Phillips. But again, this guy just wasn't pleasant to play. I did not enjoy playing this match, despite the fact that I could score, not easily, but fairly easily. I did try and score quite a few nice goals, but they weren't really coming off. Again, Ramirez put Balotelli through, and that's an easy finish. I don't know why he brought his keeper out a little bit and then decided not, but yeah, this guy was an absolute jerk. And that's 4-0. And to make, just spot the foul here. I got a penalty for that. Prove you shouldn't just keep pressing square or circle depending on your button layout. And just to bookend the three goals in between, Arteta scores another penalty to make it 5-0. And that is, thankfully, the end of that match. We can move on and forget about it ever happened. If you ever come across Furash again, either rage quit before the match starts or just don't play him to start with. What an arsehole. Just ruins the game. It's not fun to play a person like that, but I do get 957 coins. That is a nice thing to do. And I will show you the match stats as well, and you will see how well on top I was. This guy just had no skill, no imagination, no intention of playing anything other than tackle game. And yeah, 5-0. Screw you. Don't ever play me again, son. And this guy is called London. I played London. Building up a somewhat weird team, but decent team. He had a Buffon in the net that was almost impossible to break down. But this is the last match, and Balotelli, strength, finish. What can you say? He is a beast of a player. I may actually sell Darren Bent, because he's not fitting into this formation very well. There are better players that I can have, that maybe not as high a rating, but yeah. Well, enjoy these three corners, because I don't understand how Balotelli managed to score that. It hit his head and looped over the goalkeeper and went in, and he got glitched out on the old corner flag over there. That was pretty weird. I literally couldn't stop the celebration. I sent a message to the guy saying, "I'm sorry, I can't stop the celebration," and he didn't reply, so I don't think he cared too much. I just glitched out on the corner flag. It did eventually stop, and then I get another corner, and another corner doesn't get headed anywhere near. And eventually this bounces back, he doesn't clear it properly, he passes it to me. And Sami Nasri, he gets another goal for himself, and this celebration doesn't take forever. And we get another corner towards the end of the first half, and again Richardson takes these corners. I don't know why I didn't put Arteta on them, but Scholes picks up the rebound and bam, Buffon gets hands to it, but he's never going to stop that going in the net. And this guy decided he had enough, he took the centre again. But then a few seconds later, rage quit. But yeah, that is the four matches for this episode, and that is the end of this episode. 789 coins. It brings us to a small landmark in the series, as in we've reached a milestone of just over 10,000 coins, I think you're about to see. I was well on top in that half, 14 and 8 shots. There you go, 10,441, which is roughly 5% of what we need. On our way. Anyway, I've been Canty PS3. You guys have been awesome. Until next time, take care.